Hello, I am Vaishali. Today I am here with the question number 3 on degeneracy problem. Okay, so this is the given problem. Objective function maximize z, 5x1 minus 2x2 plus 3x3. Okay, the three constraint, okay, depending on the three decision variables. Now step number 1. Step number 1 is to check whether the objective function is in minimum form, then you have to convert it into maximization. But it is already in maximization, so no need to change. Now step number 2. What is step number 2? Step number 2 is to check and convert the given inequalities into the equation. Okay, so now what it has become? Now converted 2x1 plus 2x2, okay, minus x3, this is the sign greater than and these are less than. So here we are going to add the slack and here we are going to add the surplus and artificial variables. Okay, got it? So surplus we have to add, that means minus 1 s1, okay, then 1 artificial plus 1 a1. Okay, now moving to the next, 3x1, okay, 3x1 minus 4x2 plus 0x3 plus 0s1 plus 0a1 plus 1s1, 1s2, okay, 1s2. Now next one, 0x1 plus x2 plus 3x3 plus 0s1 plus 0a1 plus 0s2 plus 1s3. Okay, now writing these values, 0s1 plus 0s3 plus 0 of s3. Now these are completed. This is 2, this is 3 and this is equal to 5. So these are 3 constant equations. Constraint equation. Okay, now after that we have to work for the objective function. We have to write the new objective function. Now we are solving this given degeneracy problem as by the help of the Big M method. So using Big M method, the new objective function becomes, what will be the new objective function? It is maximum z equals to, this is the old objective function. Okay, what the new objective function is? 5x1 minus 2x2 plus 3x3 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3 minus m of a1. Okay, because in Big M method, if you have seen my previous videos, for that in the case of maximization objective function, you have to write the coefficient of artificial variable as minus m. Okay, so this is the maximization form. That's why we are writing the coefficient of a1 as minus m. Okay, now moving further to solve this question by the help of the simplex method, applying the simplex table, x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, s3 and a1. Okay, so first we write the CJ because it is written here, 5 minus 2, 3, solving this, we make the simplex table. Is like this. Okay, so what are the basic variables? Basic variables will be s2, s3 and a1. Okay, artificial variable and the slack variables. Okay, so a1, s1, s2. Okay, because we have added a1 first. So values of CB will be 0, 0 and 0, but in the case of a1 it will become minus m. Okay, now for xb, coefficient values of right hand side of the constant equation, it is 2, 3, 5. Okay, so 2, 3 and 5. Got it? Now the values of the variables. Value of x1. Okay, so value of x1 will be 2, 3, 0. Writing below 2x1, 2, 3, 0. For x2, 2, minus 4 and 1. 2, minus 4 and 1. Then minus 1, 0, 3. Minus 1, 0, 3. Then for S1, minus 1. Okay. Then for S2, 1. Then for S3, 1. Then for A1, 1. Now I have written as I have added. Write the 0 remaining values. Okay. So this is the basis matrix. Now start solving this for the value of Z and for delta J. So Z is equals to minus 2M. Okay. Now what is the value of delta J? Delta J is minus 2M, minus 5M. So it will be minus 5 minus 2M. Minus 2M minus plus 2. So 2 minus 2M. Okay. 0, 0 then M. 3. So it is M minus 3. 0, 0 M. It will become M. It will become 0. 0 and 0. Okay. It will become as plus M minus M. It will become 0. Okay. Now after this, you got the value negative. This is the negative value. Okay. So what is the negative value? This is the most negative value and hence X1 will be the outgoing incoming vector. This is the most negative value. Okay. Fine. Now after this, you have to check for XB upon XK. Now what is XB upon XK? For that K become 1 here. Okay. So XB upon XK 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 5 by 0. 2 by 2, 3 by 3 and 5 by 0. This is the unique value. These two, here we got the tie. We got the tie between the first and the, we got the tie between first and second value. Okay, in the first and second value. So, there is a tie between first row and the second row. Okay, so we have to apply the degeneracy method. But before that, I want to tell you one thing. When there is a tie between artificial and slack variable, if there is a tie between artificial and slack variable, so for such circumstances, artificial and slack both will be ready to leave the base, leave the basic variable. But basis, but artificial will be preferred in leaving. So that means in such case A1 will be the outgoing vector. Okay. As in minimum ratio column, first and second both values is 1. So either A1 or S2 tend to leave the basis. Okay. Tend to leave the basis. Here, out of artificial and slack variable, artificial variable will be preferred and leave the basis. So in this problem, no need to apply the degeneracy processor. So when you get such type of processor, such type of problem, when there is a tie between artificial and slack variable, you have to remove the artificial variable first thing. Second thing, no need to apply the degeneracy processor because tie is resolved. Under such circumstances, you have to continue the simplex table. Okay? Under such circumstances, continuing the simplex table. Okay? It means that you have to now continue the simplex table. Okay? Now starting with the simplex table. This is the simplex table, okay, and this is the last one, okay, the last step which we have done. So, A1 will be replaced by which? A1 will be replaced by X1, okay. So, now writing X1 here, okay, X1, then S2, then S3, okay, S2, S3, okay. The value of CJ. The value of the CJ will remain the same. Okay, this is 5 minus 2, 3. So, I am going to write it here. 5 minus 2, 3, 0, 0, 0. Now, A1 is removed from the table. Okay. Now, the value of X1. X1 value is 5. So, we are going to write 5 here. Remaining S2 and S3 is 0, 0. So, we will write 0, 0 here. Okay. Fine, 0, 0. The value of C. Now after that we have to apply the transformation so that we make the value 1 here and the remaining is 0, 0. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to divide the full this row. From here till here, we have to divide this row throughout by 2 so that we get 1 here. Then we have to apply the transformation that we have to transform this to. We have to change it to 0. This is already 0, so we can copy this line as such. Okay, so now dividing this line throughout by 2, what we get? 1, 1, 1, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, 0, 0, and 1 by 2. Okay, so removing this, we don't write this, so till 0 we have to write. So I am writing this value as 1, 1, 1, then minus 1 by 2, then minus 1 by 2, then 0 and 0. Okay, the last one is also same. This one is also same. So 5, 0, 1, okay, 5, 0, 1. And 3 similarly we have to write. This is 5, then 0, then 1, 3, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0 and 1. So this is also copied. Now this one, the second row. The second row we have to divide throughout by 3 and then we have to subtract it from the first row, R1. Okay, so what we get? We get the value as 0, 0, minus 7, 3 by 2, then 3 by 2, then 1 and 0. So we get all the values for the first iteration in the simplex table. This is called as first iteration. Okay, first iteration in the simplex table. Now again we have to do the same to find the incoming vector and to find the outgoing vector. Then we have to check the value of the smallest of incoming vector. Okay, like that. What is the value of z? Z is 5. Now start finding delta j. You very well know CB into XJ minus of CJ. So 5 minus 5 it will become 0. Okay, the one thing I have done is I have removed artificial variable from this table. Okay, so this is the chain. Apart from that, all the things are same. You know very well in my previous videos I have done many questions of such type of tables. Okay, for solving such type of simplex tables. Now this is 5, this is 0, 0 minus 2. So that means it will become 5 plus 2. So it will become 7. Okay. Now minus 5 by 2. 0, 0. Then minus 3. So we get minus 11 by 2. Then we get minus 5 by 2. 0 and 0. Okay. Now after this you have to find the incoming vector. What is the incoming vector? The smallest of all. So this is the smallest. This is the incoming vector. So x3 will be selected as the incoming vector. This is the key column. Okay, this is the key column. Now you have to work for the minimum ratio. So for that case, xb upon xk and k will become 3 here. So xb upon x3. Okay, so negative 1 we will not consider. Okay, 0 by 3 is 0, 5 by 3 is 5. Okay, 0 and 5 by 3. Okay, so this is the, okay, now 0, 1 is the smallest. So this will be selected as the outgoing vector. Now again solving the same process. So this is your pivot element. So x1, s2 will be replaced by x3. S3 is as such. So 5, x3 value is 3. So it will become 3. S3 is 0. Now we have to divide this line by 2 by 3 so that we get this as 1. Okay, so dividing by 2 by 3 what we get? Minus 14 by 3, then 1, then 1, then 2 by 3, then 0. Okay, hope you understand this. Now we have to make this and this 0. Why? Because we are replacing x3. We are going to replace S2 by X3. So we are making the element of X3 as the element of S2. Okay. So now we have to multiply this line by 1 by 2. Then we add second row, this row R2 plus R1. Okay. First we have to multiply this by 1 by 2. So what we got? We get this as 1, 1 minus 4 by 3. Okay, then 0, 0, 1 by 3 and 0. Okay, what we have done? This is R2. If I say this is R2, so we have done R2 into 1 by 2. Okay, then this is R1. Okay, so we have done R1 minus R2. This is equal to R2. This is equal to R1. So this operation we have applied. Okay. Similarly, for the third row, we have to multiply R2 by 3, then R3. R3 minus 3 of R2 gives you the value of R3. This we have done in the, this we are going to do in the third one. So what we get? We get the value as 5, 0, 15, 0, 0, 2 and 1. So we got this as the value. So after that again we have to do the same. We have to find the value of Z. What is Z? Z equal to 5. Okay. Then we have to find the value of delta J. Delta J is XB upon XJ minus CJ. So we get the value of 0. Then we get minus 56 by 3. How we get minus 56 by 3? XB upon XJ, sorry, CB upon XJ minus CJ. So what is CB? This is minus 20 by 3. Means 5 into minus 4 by 3 is minus 20 by 3. Then plus 3 into minus 14 by 3. Okay. Then minus minus plus 2. This one. This is plus 2. Okay. So we get the value as minus 56 by 3. We get the value as minus 56 by 3. What is the remaining values as 0, 3, 11 by 3 and 0. Okay. Now, we have to find the most negative value. Only one negative value is this. So that means x2 will be the selected as the incoming vector. Now after that we have to solve for minimum ratio as we got the incoming vector. That means these two is already removed from minimum ratio because these are the negative values. Only one is left. No need to solve. You know that this will be the incoming, sorry, this will be the outgoing vector. This is the column and this is the row. So 15 will be the pivot element. See, similarly, you have to do the remaining two iterations. I have already solved. Okay, I have already solved this because this video is going very lengthy and this I have told you many times and I hope you understand these steps very well. Okay, so similarly you have to do for this. So this will be the outgoing vector. Okay, S3. So S3 will be replaced by X2 here in the coming iteration. S3 will be replaced by X2. Okay, similarly you have to make this as 1 and the remaining all the element in the same column as 0. So you have to solve again for delta J. If you get the negative value then again you have to solve another iteration. Okay, another iteration is solved and then in the delta J you got all the positive values. As in the last, this is the fourth iteration. First, second, third, fourth. Fourth iteration I got all the delta J's are positive. That means this LP possesses the optimal solution. And what is the answer? Answer is Z is equals to 85 by 3. Okay. X1 is equals to 2 by 3. X2 is equals to 5. And X3 is 0. Okay. So this is your final solution. Okay. My main aim is to tell you about that when you are having the tie between the artificial and the slack variable, artificial will be preferred as an outgoing vector. No need to apply further degeneracy processor. Okay, hope you understand this question well. Okay, please try to solve this by yourself because this I have told you many times. Okay, hope you understand this question well. Please like and subscribe my channel. And if you are having any problem related to operation research topic, please post your comment. I'll try to give your answer as early as possible. Okay, like, subscribe and share my channel. Okay, thanks.